عندما يأتي الصالح الموعود سيعمد إلى أهل هذه الدنيا فيخلصهم من الضلال والفقر كأهل مصر وينجيهم من كيد الظالمين.
تتحكم جدلية الوحدة والتنوع في التاريخ الإنساني، فالتنوع الديني والمذهبي والاختلاف العرقي والتعدد اللساني لا يلغي البتة نقاط مشتركة كثيرة بين البشر، فقد كانت المجتمعات الإنسانية بمختلف تمثلاتها وعلى مدى التاريخ ترنو إلى إله خالق، ولذلك لم تخلو حضارة من الحضارات من معبد أو مكان لتقديس الإله وعبادته. ومن مظاهر الوحدة بين هذه المجتمعات الإيمان بالمخلص، فباستقراء التاريخ الديني والثقافي للإنسانية نجد أن مفهوم المخلص ومبدأ الخلاص قاسم مشترك بين أكثر الحضارات، وإن كانت تختلف فيما بينها في حدود هذا المفهوم وعمقه وتفاصيله ومشخصاته. فالبوذيون مثلا ينتظرون مخلصهم بوذا مترقبين عودته، وكذلك قدامى المصريين حيث دلت كتاباتهم وآثارهم على انتظارهم للمخلص، والكلام نفسه يصح على قدامى الصينيين، ولا مراء أن كل من اليهود والنصارى يؤمنون بمخلصهم أيضا، والهنود يعتقدون بعودة فيشنو وغيرهم كثيرين. أما المسلمون فإنهم على اختلاف مذاهبهم وفرقهم يعتقدون بالمهدي الذي هو من ولد النبي الخاتم محمد صلى الله عليه وآله، والذي سيظهر في آخر الزمان ويملأ الأرض قسطا وعدلا.
The Imam will fill the world with justice in 5 ways. The Imam will fill the world with economic justice and prosperity. There is an unequal distribution of the wealth. Most of the wealth is owned by the minority, and there's a huge gap between the wealthy and the poor. The Imam al-Mahdi, amongst the things that he will do, is that he will put an end to this. There will be equality for everyone in the economic resources of the world. There will be equality for everyone. And there will be absolutely no poor people. The hadith of the Imam, it's beautiful, says this, وَيَطْلُبْ مِنْكُمْ الرَّجُلْ مَنْ يَصِلْهُ بِمَالِهِ وَيَأْخُذْ مِنْهُ زَكَاتَهُ. He says that during the time of Imam al-Mahdi, there will be economic equality to this extent, that you will go out and search for a faqir, for a poor person. Why? Because you want to give him sadaqah. The Imam says you will not find any poor person. No one will accept your money. Does not have any needs. The second type is that the world will be safe, secure, peace. There will be absolutely no violence. The Imam will put an end to the wars, to the destruction, to crimes. And our ahadith indicate that peace will be so predominant during that time. Allah says in the Holy Quran, قُلْ سِيرُ فِيهَا لَيَالِيَ وَأَيَّامًا آمِنِينَ. Imam al-Sadiq, he asked Abu Hanifa one day, he told him, what is the tafsir of this verse? Abu Hanifa told him, Allah is speaking about Mecca and Medina. The Imam looked at his companions, he told them, how many of you have, for example, been robbed between Mecca and Medina? How many people have been killed? So the Imam tells him, obviously, Allah is not speaking about Mecca and Medina now. Allah is speaking about what? He's speaking about the time of Imam al-Mahdi, complete peace, in which every individual will wish to live under the rule of the Imam. Then one hadith says, وَيَظْهَرْ مِنَ الْعَدْلِ مَا يَتَمَنَّ الْأَحْيَاءُ لَهُ الْأَمْوَاتِ. Thank you.
البعد الثالث البعد العلمي، التكامل العلمي الذي يحدث في عهد الإمام الحجة صلوات الله عليه ليس له نظير في تاريخ البشرية. عن الإمام الصادق صلوات الله عليه: العلم 27 حرفا، فجميع ما جاءت به الرسل حرفان. فإذا قام المهدي صلوات الله عليه أخرج 25 حرفا فبثها في الناس وضم إليها الحرفين حتى يبثها 27 حرفا. وهنالك رواية أخرى أيضا عن الإمام الباقر صلوات الله عليه: وتؤتون الحكمة في زمانه حتى أن المرأة لتقضي في بيتها بكتاب الله وسنة نبيه صلى الله عليه وسلم. يعني العلم كله يظهر في ذلك العهد.
Justice towards nature. A hadith state that before the Imam comes, there will be injustice everywhere. Amongst the forms of injustice that we see is injustice against nature. This is a type of injustice that we never pay attention to. Imam al-Mahdi will implement this. He will bring justice at every level, meaning even justice with nature. That one hadith says that when a person leaves from Iraq and goes to Sham, every place they place their foot on will be grass and plants. So this is how the Imam will preserve what? He will preserve the nature. Justice at a social level, at the family level, and even at the personal level. The Imam will ensure there's justice between the family, the parents and their children, between me and other individuals in the society and community. And the only way you can ensure that there is justice between societies, between the people of the society, and between the family is by what? Spreading akhlaq. If you teach people akhlaq and morals, they will automatically be just. And once you have akhlaq, once you have morality, crime rate will be less, and injustice will be less, because people will respect each other. And that's why the Imam, the akhlaq, and the moral system that he will spread and teach will be like human beings had never seen.